Hey everyone, this is a lucid dreaming video. It's been a while since I've made one, but here it is. Lucid dreaming is getting a weird reputation recently, and as much as I've tried my absolute darndest to get back on track of what lucid dreaming should be, it seems that I'm in the minority. I'm in the minority because I believe that dreams and lucid dreaming occurs entirely in the mind. Most, unfortunately, believe that lucid dreaming is part of an esoteric force, in which you leave your body during the night, your physical body, and you enter the astral world. Therefore, all lucid dreams are astral projections. I'm here to say, no, they're not. Dreams occur in the mind. We have documented this many times in the past. I'm unclear as to why so many people are quick to jump to the conclusion that it's all mystical. And I understand that, being a lucid dreamer, we have to kind of have the belief system that consciousness is something bigger than what society portrays it to be. However, along the way, as a collective, we've dismissed the basic facts of lucid dreaming, and we've jumped kind of like feet first into the data without having a look, just because it feels right. And a while back, I was one of those people. I used to believe in things not because of the information that is presented to me, but because of the feeling that I have in my heart. I believe it to be true, therefore it is, kind of mentality. And I recognize, that there should be some kind of like mind-heart discrepancies. This is how research topics are usually formed. It's not just a hypothesis that's created as a logical step. Sometimes it's like, I wonder what would happen if kind of scenario. However, when it comes to basic facts, this way of thinking is just ludicrously dangerous. And it's kind of counterproductive towards, not just lucid dreaming, but other types of research fields. And I know, side note, that James from Space Time Badass does not necessarily think that lucid dreaming counts as a field of research, but I do. And I recognize that it is in a grey area, kind of like how video games are considered a sport. It's a grey area. What? So my advice, as someone who's been in this area of study for a while, is to recognize that the information that you receive isn't necessarily always true. It's important to understand that you have to discern the fact from fiction, because someone else isn't going to do it for you, and they shouldn't do it for you either. Always decode your facts that you learn from different sources, whether it be me, Daniel Love, James Coy Fresco, Charlie Morley, whoever it may be, anywhere. Don't accept facts from face values, because we as individuals might be wrong, and collectively we could be wrong as well. No matter where you hear information from, you have to do the important thing. Think about it. We all have a friend or a family member who's said to you in the past, "Oh, so you heard it on the internet, therefore it must be true." Which is funny, yeah. It's got some valid point to it.
I don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay. Do you understand that? Turn the friggin' frogs gay. Serious crap.
Just because you hear it from the internet doesn't necessarily mean it's true. Similarly, I think that the phrase should be applied to every type of media. Oh, you heard it on the news, so it must be true. Oh, you heard it on the radio, so it must be true. You read it in a paper, must be true. You read it in a book, oh, so it must be true. Because everything you hear, it must be true. Being well-read is one thing. Getting information from different sources is a good thing as well. However, it's pointless to have all of these streams of information coming to you from all of these different places if you don't think about what it is you've just read or what it is you've just heard. Just because one source or more than one source says something doesn't make it true. And this is where many people lack. It's the critical thinking aspect of it. One of the reasons that people think of lucid dreaming as an esoteric practice and they're stuck in an esoteric point of view is because of something that I can relate to, and I've previously mentioned in this video. It feels right, so it must be right. We've all had situations in which we see, hear, touch, taste, smell something that is so real that it bears thinking about as to how that couldn't be true. Most dreams are like this. To misquote Cobb from Inception, he says, "If dreams didn't feel real, then we'd always know that we're in one." Again, I said misquote, I can't remember it off the top of my head. But just like information, senses can be deceiving. For example, sleep paralysis. I know I mentioned it in the last video I made, but it's a hallucination made by the brain. And yet, because people have these truly horrendous experiences of sleep paralysis that can be so clear and so damn vivid, it makes it impossible to believe that it's anything else than real. For example, it could be a demon. If you were to talk to a regular Joe about your experiences of sleep paralysis, they may look you in shock and think, "Oh well, is this really a genuine horrid experience that people can have?" And you go, "Yeah, it is." But when you start to add things like demons into the mix, it turns it on its head. You'll think less like, "Oh wow, this is a weird phenomenon, and it will turn it into, oh, okay, I don't think so because of demons. However, they only think that because the regular Joe doesn't have a frame of reference into the cause of the experience, nor has he had the experience to feel empathetic towards you. I don't mean to say that, like, you have to filter what you say and not tell the truth, but to be more cautious of how you say things and who you say them to, because other people aren't on the same level of information as you. Let me talk about lucid dreaming specifically, because this is getting off topic a little bit. It's important to utilize what we know, so stick to the bare bones of information. Dreams occur in the mind, and if you believe otherwise, then why? What information are you using, and where are you getting this information from to form an opinion that dreams and lucid dreaming occur elsewhere than inside the brain? If it's because it feels to be right, doesn't necessarily mean it is. I've said this in a video that I made before called Why Coy Fresco is Wrong, and it's the simple fact of the truth is the truth, and always will be, regardless of your opinion. So why bother thinking about something other than what is the right information? However, I do recognize that there are some gray areas in which this, like this phrase, truth is the truth and always will be, regardless of your opinion, because that will just fall apart, especially when we're talking about philosophy and societal issues. For example, the truth is difficult when you're talking about morality, abortion, jail sentences. How do you quantify how much time you give a prison sentence for a crime that's committed, which is ultimately subjective in nature? But for things like dreams, lucidity, these have somewhat black and white issues in them. Where do we dream? In the mind. All of the information we have points to this simple fact. So let's start from there. In conclusion, we need to think more about facts. If we know categorically that something is to be true, then we need to accept it for what it is. Truth. This is one of the reasons why my opinions changed on my belief about astral projection. It is a lucid dream, because we have the facts for it, regardless of my subjective opinion. Subjectivity in facts is counterproductive for the most part. Again, I recognize that subjectivity is an important factor to push theories forward. We wouldn't have facts about lucid dreaming if it wasn't for people's thoughts about lucid dreaming subjectivity. Subjectively. What I mean by that is, like, if Keith Hearn and Alan Worsley didn't have the subjective experience of lucid dreaming, they would never have scientifically researched it. Therefore, we wouldn't have the cold hard facts about lucidity that we have today, and we've been able to push the field of research forward. With that said, if you can repeat a fact time and time again in like a lab, then it's a fact, and it's time to move on. I know what I've said and how I've said it has come across as quite cold and factual, but I'm not that black and white. I know people think I am, but genuinely, I'm not really that black and white. I am very open to different interpretations of ideas. For example, if someone was to tell me that God was real and give me proof that God was real, I'd believe that God was real. I'm open to the idea. I'm not a closed-minded person. I like to look at the facts of something before I judge it. Similarly, if someone was to prove that sleep paralysis exists because demons have pushed that onto people, and someone was to be able to prove that, then I wouldn't be closed-minded enough to be able to go, oh, no, it's not demons, because demons don't exist. Someone can prove it, I'll believe it. Likewise, if someone was to prove that lucid dreams do occur in an astral plane, then yeah, I'd believe it, even though I don't. My opinion can be changed if, say, in the future, we have better machinery and better equipment that are more capable to be able to accurately measure esoteric, like, data. But right now, given with the information that we have, it's not something that I can believe in, because it's not something to believe in when we have the facts. And that's pretty much it for today. I'd like to say a big thank you to all of my Patreon supporters who have supported the show thus far. Thank you very much, each and every single one of you. I know some of you are wondering about the new, like, podcast and the new tough topics that are coming out. Yes, they are coming out. They're coming out slower than I anticipated them to come out. So just give me a little bit of time to get those sorted. Turns out getting people to talk to me, well, not specifically me, turns out getting people to talk in their free time for free is difficult. It's challenging when people live on opposite sides of the world. Okay, that's pretty much it for today. I've just slumped so far down into my chair. If you want to subscribe to the channel, then please do so. If you want to click here and watch my latest video, then please do that as well. And all links, as per usual, are in the description box below. And until next time, bye!